drumstick and a hijack. Oh, win everyone. And a hijack music stick. I have used. Hang on, let me turn this down. I have used the weirdest things over the years to prop my phone up for classes. We've used random books. We've used weights and like created stuff. I almost feel like it's going to take away some of the authenticity of the ministry when I have an actual tripod. Alright. So like I said, you need drumsticks. Have them handy. We don't need them right off the bat, but we will. And you will need a chair. We're going to do a slightly different Tabata than we did last week. Some the same, some different. But instead of having the strength, cardio, we're going to do a straight strength Tabata with a chair. We're going to do triceps, lower core, and then hips. So that's what we're going to be focusing on in our Tabata today. So, let's go ahead and get started and get moving. And more importantly, let's get louder.
Combo
next. Punch, punch,
rapper. You should call me trail rapper. I'm that boy that's putting on.
Double up.
I'm that put me in a circle of some L rappers. And now I'm right about God then.
Come up. Hit.
Back to the subject.
Bend those knees just nice and soft.
No subject. Whooping on this beat, boy. And I ain't got no gloves yet.
Thank you.
Grab your chair and grab a drink. Woo! Grab your chair and grab a drink. We're going to use our chair for our Tabata strength. We're going to use our own body weight to create our resistance. Woo! I'll show you what we're going to do. Then, today is only two scriptures, but I hope that they soak in deep. Remember, this month we're talking about walking the walk because we're surrounded by such a great cloud of witnesses. We're talking about talking the talk and doing what we say, not saying do as I do, say, not as I do. Because it's important to set an example. We talked about that out of 2 Titus a couple weeks ago. So we're going to continue on that theme tonight as we jump into 1 Peter chapter 5. But first, let me show you what's up. So, this is going to be a true Tabata, so you're going to have 20 seconds of hard work with a 10-second break in between. Okay? Owen, you know how to do all these. Are you ready?
Yeah.
Okay, just checking. We're going to start with our arms with our tricep dips. Walk your feet out. Bring your booty off of your chair. You don't want your knees to go over your toes. So pull it back so they're lined up. Then we're going to bend our elbows, keep them in tight, close to the body, to come down and back up. Make sure it's your elbows bending that brings you up and down, not your hips. Okay, because we want to target that tricep. 20 seconds there, 10-second break. Then we're going to move down our body into our core with leg lifts. We did these last week, too. You have two options on your leg lifts. I like to come a little forward in my chair and lean back so I can have that backrest. I end up usually grabbing down close to the leg, but you grab wherever feels comfortable for you. Two options. Remember, we're targeting the lower abdomen. You can either alternate one leg at a time, and I'll do that some, or you can do both legs together. Try and keep it controlled up and controlled down. Don't just crash back down to earth, okay? 20 seconds there. 10 seconds to kind of sit up, shake it out, and now this is the new thing. Instead of doing our cardio walk, we're going to do hip, adductor, abductor, okay? So you're going to come up a little bit in your chair just so you can have good posture. If you want to grip the bottom of your chair, you're welcome to. And we're just going to open the hips, close. Open, close. Okay? Our core is going to be utilized to keep us stable, so you are going to get some abdominal work here. But we're primarily working the inner and outer thigh and that hip flexor with that out and in. Out and in. Okay? Knees stay bent. 20 seconds there, 10-second break, and then we go right back to the triceps. We're going to rotate those three. Make sense? Okay, cool. So here's our first scripture. This is 1 Peter 5, 2 through 4. Care for the flock that God has entrusted to you. Watch over it willingly, not grudgingly. Not for what you will get out of it, but because you are eager to serve God. Don't lord it over the people assigned to your care, but lead them by your own good, what's our buzzword? Example. Lead them by your own good example. And when the great shepherd appears, you will receive a crown of never-ending glory and honor. The Lord has entrusted each one of us with a flock. Remember, we all have a crowd of witnesses. Whether or not we hold the title of leader or teacher or minister or whatever title you want to use, we all have a flock. God has entrusted us to our homes. He has entrusted us to our friends. He's entrusted us to extended family. Whatever flock God has given you, treat it with care. Because God chose those exact people for you in this time. And the best way that we can lead them is by example. The best way we can lead them is by example. Okay, I'll have the timer set up at the foot of my chair so you can see it. 15-second warning. instead of the short ones.
That would probably be.
Here, come here. You might have to dig. If you see glitter, there we go.
Here, buddy.
Here you go. Special Owen stick. I gave them to him. Yeah, he might want those. All right, going into our drumming section. We're not using weights, pal.
Come here, come on.
He's going to go get them out of my car and be real disappointed.
No.
All right. I want us to really be considering who is the flock that God has entrusted to us individually. It's very easy to start looking at the flock in your neighbor's pasture. We think, oh, they have the title that matters. They have so many more people that look up to them. But what's important to remember is that if God would tell a story about losing one coin and going after it, or losing one sheep and going after it, or celebrating one son who comes home, if God will celebrate one, in that same area of the Bible, Jesus says, all of heaven rejoices over one sinner who comes home. If God will rejoice for the one, it does not matter if you have one or 100 people who are listening to you, who are called to you, who are entrusted to you, your flock. Each one matters to God. So we can't be looking at other people's pastures and counting their sheep and then being dissatisfied with our own. Because numbers only matter to people. Numbers don't matter to God. And the flock that has been entrusted to you, whether it be a formal class setting, a pulpit, or saying grace around a dinner table at night, your flock matters. And what you do with your flock matters. So we owe it to our flock to teach them by example. So as we move our bodies with our sticks tonight, I want you to just kind of asking God, who's my flock? Who's in my pasture? Who have you entrusted to me to teach by example? Okay, we're going to stay all on one side.
That's what we get in the bottle, but the bottle like all about the steel trying to box him when you ever gonna die. Yo, baby, my prayer is the cats are made up where he is. Infinite preeminence, their images is all his.
Swear up. just bring your legs in. Keep doing what we're doing with our arms, though. Right up.
In humility. What does that look like for you in this season?
And what does that look like specifically for you and the flock he has entrusted to you? Here's your 15-second warning. And here's your words.
The Lord is the strength of my life. Whom shall I be afraid?
Go ahead and start.
Even my enemies and my foes came upon me. They stumbled and fell. Though a host should encamp against me, my heart shall not fear it. Though war should rise against me, in this I will be confident. I've got a promise. Turning back is not an option. There's a calling on my life. I'm not about to drop. I got this. For this I was chosen. The final word will be spoken before I was born. I have a purpose that goes far beyond.
If you want, like I said, you have the option of a bed.
What I see, what they say cannot be. With God, all things are possible. When my desire aligns with the divine, I am unstoppable. In this, I will be confident. Of course, the climb is hard. I'm not surprised. The dream is difficult by design. To make sure I rely on his mind, not mine.
10-second break. Get ready for your play.
My assignment was conceived in his heart, his mind. And the blessing ahead will always be greater than the time behind.
Go.
So this is not the time to compromise. Entertain a thousand lies and a million reasons why I can't, or it won't, or it's not, or I'll never. I've heard it before, so shut up, devil. God didn't say he'd make it easy. He said he'd make me better, make me strong, and give me grace to carry on. No matter what the opposition, I only need one weapon. I have the faith to overcome. In this, I will be confident. I'm too close to quit, and the stakes are too great for me to hesitate. So whatever it costs, whatever it takes, I'll keep coming. I show up, take the shot, my hands shaking. The fear is real, but it won't break me. God will not fail me, nor forsake me. I'll keep coming. I'll step to the battle like it's already won. Like I got the enemy on the run.
Woo!
I speak and believe like it's already done. In this, I will be confident. He made me a promise. He gave me a call. I know that he's able.
This one for the Lord.
opening up that left hip. Bring that knee towards your chest, figure four or reclined pigeon. Go ahead and put that foot down. Flatten both feet. We're going to windshield wipe them side to side. Taking it to your side. Rolling up to a comfortable seated position. Good. And we're going to go ahead and stretch that arm across. Good. Take that same elbow back, stretch your triceps. Good job, Owen. Bring it down, switch sides. Keep that shoulder down away from your ear. Push that elbow back. And bring it down, good. Roll the neck around. Other way. Big inhale up. Exhale down. We're going to read our scriptures aloud one more time, and then I'll pray us out for tonight. Care for the flock that God has entrusted to you. Watch over it willingly, not grudgingly. Not for what you will get out of it, but because you are eager to serve God. Don't lord it over the people assigned to your care, but lead them by your own good example. And when the good shepherd appears, you will receive a crown of never-ending glory and honor. In the same way, you younger men must accept the authority of the elders. And all of you, serve each other in humility. For God opposes the proud, but favors the humble. So humble yourselves under the mighty power of God, and at the right time, he will lift you up in honor. Let's go ahead and pray. Yeah. Dear Heavenly Father God, I thank you so much for the flock that you've given me. God, I love each and every person under the sound of my voice right now or in replay so much, and it is my honor to serve them. Lord, I pray that I can teach them by example and that I can walk with humility. Lord, I just thank you so much for the honor and the pleasure it is. Lord, there are a few people in our Faithful Fitness family that are struggling right now. Lord, I know we have a Faithful Fitness family member who's having some heart issues right now, who's going to be going in for some test results. Lord, I pray that you be with her, guide her, love her, comfort her, heal her. And I pray that you feel the love and the power and the prayers of all of us lifting her up. And Lord, we also have a family member who's had a death in a family very close to her. Lord, as she navigates this situation, Lord, I pray that you be with the family who is suffering a loss, but I pray that you also be with those surrounding them. Lord, to give them the words to speak and the words not to speak. God, that they can be an example of you in a time of mourning. That they can turn them to you, the great comforter. Lord, I bless each and every one of the people that you've entrusted to me, Lord. I'm humbled and I thank you. In Jesus' name, I pray. Amen.
Whew.
Yeah. I know, right? Turn the air down, the fan on. I'm still going to have to wash my hair again. We are continuing to collect for the backpacks, fill the backpacks. So I have the backpack here. The rest of the month, if you want to bring any school supplies and put in the backpack, you're welcome to. Or if you want to donate cash, we'll go buy the school supplies for you. That's fine, too. And at the end of the month, I'll let you know what I'll take a picture of everything that we got and collected with that. But I will see you guys next week or tomorrow or Thursday or Saturday or Monday. I'll see you. Oh, Rhonda, I miss you too.